What's up, bitches? Welcome to Epileptic Gaming's Faces for Radio. I'm djWheat, not quite feeling myself, and of course, cohort in crime, we've got the world famous Robert Suma, and as always, because we don't have phone lines anymore on Epileptic Gaming, we are going to be opening the phone lines today to you. And there's a lot to talk about.
Oh, yeah, there is.
There's a lot to talk about.
Oh, yeah, there is.
Even if we look at the non-gaming items that are
the
available for discussion.
Television, bar none, maybe?
Yeah, dude, bar none, I would say.
I mean, has there ever been a better night of, like, especially two shows?
I don't know. It doesn't happen very often,
even
dude.
In the must-see TV days, I'm not sure if there was anything as great as what happened last night.
I think that last night in Survivor and Lost, both epic moments, as we learned quite a bit about both series.
Pretty amazing.
One a reality show, and of course the other, just the greatest show on television, pretty much.
What's that?
Lost.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So, also on things to discuss today is Tanette sort of tried to light me up today in the forums, or EG in general, just saying that, you know, we're fucking ignorant. And we don't know what we're talking about. Specifically, he was discussing the whole concept of PC gaming being dead or us, you know, even discussing it, Suma. That's the one thing, I guess, that just sort of fucking boggles my mind, right? It's like, you
How
know,
dare you?
They bitch, right?
How dare you, sir?
They want us to talk about PC gaming. I bring in a relevant argument. I think Cliffy B commenting on the fact that Epic's focus is no longer on PCs, but console... I don't know how that gets misconstrued into, like, us saying that PC gaming is dying.
I love the fact that he goes, you can't take Cliffy B seriously when it comes to PC gaming.
What? You know, a guy that fucking started out making games like Jazz Jackrabbit,
that
okay?
Even begin to make
this
sense.
Guy started at, like, the heyday of PC download, or, you know, where I would I'd fucking dial up some BBS with my 2400 baud modem, and it would take me like 8 hours to fucking download like Jazz Jackrabbit or Doom or any of the Apogee games that were out there, you know? I don't get it. I don't get it. How could you not, like, have Cliffy B, a guy that made his mark in the industry, right? As a PC-centric individual. I don't think you could have a better spokesperson for that.
Exactly. I mean, here's a guy who was probably he was probably really hardcore PC guy.
Probably. Dude, come on.
It probably took a lot for him to go convert to consoles. And then Epic itself is, you know, saying that they're going to focus now on consoles. I mean, that says a lot.
I think it says tons.
Mod supporters and just I mean, you want to talk about mods, Tenet. I mean, the king of mods almost, right? Is Epic, would you say? I mean, sort of.
Well, I don't know. I mean, I think when he's talking about mods and community mods, right. You know, things like total conversions that guys make, okay. You know, things like different game types, competitive mods, et cetera, et cetera. But I don't think those are flourishing quite as
upset.
Much as they used to.
I think he's upset we're saying PC is dying, but
I don't think we ever even said PC is dying. Like, you said PC gaming
right,
is
but
dying.
But that's not to be meant to be taken literally. It's just like, as you said in the forums, in retrospect to its heyday, it's just not what it was. So
yes.
That's just sort of the catchphrase that
exactly.
You know, we like to say, like, it's dying.
I'm sorry like that I want to use history to establish, you know, arguments and points, but the bottom line is that when I first got into PC gaming, Suma, it was at its heyday. You know, consoles were separated because PC gaming just dwarfed what consoles were capable of. Now that we've reached this point in time where it's like, yeah, okay, I know the PS3 and the fucking 360 can't run Crysis the way that a PC can, but it still doesn't, you know,
But, you know,
I don't think that does not necessarily mean that PC gaming isn't on the decline or isn't not dying because there's a game out on PC that consoles can't run. There's no logic to that, really.
Yeah. And guys, when people say PC is dying, it's just the same thing as when you go, oh, I'm starving. You're not really starving. You're just hungry. Okay.
Good point, Robert.
Same
Suma.
Thing.
God.
So try not to take everything
everybody says
on the internet or elsewhere.
Someone
so
marked down
literally
that like 13 minutes into the show, Suma said something intelligent. I'm fucking.
I love how every show now that people need to point that out. Haven't you just got it by now that maybe I am intelligent and maybe everything I say has some intelligence behind it? I mean, do I have to see a post like every day or a comment that's like, oh my God, he said something intelligent? Yeah, I see that every show now. especially this shirt.
I had to change shirts today, dude. Can I just talk about my day and how crappy it's been? And then, we'll start taking some phone calls. So let's rewind all the way back to about 8 o'clock this morning, when I was trying to leave my house.
You're QQing this morning.
I was QQing, dude. QQ. I called
major QQ mode,
dude. Okay. So for those of you guys that don't know, the real deal is that I do suffer from, I guess, self-diagnosed OCD, and I can't claim to be like, I don't know what an extreme case of OCD is, but I think I have a pretty fucking good idea, because this morning I couldn't find my phone, so I decided I was just going to stay there for 90 minutes while I looked in the same places over and over and over again. It didn't matter if I looked under that pillow once. I would look under that pillow twice and three times and four times and five times, thinking that maybe there's a fucking chance, a small one even, that the phone might just reappear underneath that pillow for some strange fucking reason.
Pillow?
And it didn't. So I have lost my phone at this point. It's kind of like...
Your son's probably calling China right now.
Dude, who knows?
China?
And of course, trying to get James to help out. Here's what James, where's China? Daddy's phone?
Sumo?
Daddy phone? Daddy phone, where are you? Yeah. If it was that fucking easy, I would have found it, a few minutes after...
And then
after
you don't believe me.
It.
He's like, is it in your bag? No, I looked. It's not in there. Are you sure?
It's not that I didn't believe you. It's that I had more confidence in the fact that probably my kid would have done something as stupid as put
then
that
you
in your bag.
Have confidence in me looking and knowing it's not
that
there?
That I don't have confidence in you. And no, I'm sorry. So mark that one up as big
and
shitty.
Yes, he did try calling it, but the sucker puts it on vibrate. So even if he did try to find it, it'd be almost
impossible. But see, here's the funny thing, right? Last night we're watching Lost, and like it's quiet, and there's like some suspenseful scene, and all of a sudden you hear.
I don't remember that. I remember hearing a little something during Rock Band. That's about it.
That's the simulation of the phone vibrating. I heard it. I know it's somewhere.
Are you sure it wasn't your dildo?
I think that it was in my ass. I think that I don't know, man. Maybe it was the fucking Oceanic Flight 815 wormhole that my phone flew into, and now 33 minutes later, it's going to pop out.
Oh, I forgot to look at the lost forms. So busy today with this Olympic stuff.
So, yeah, Olympic stuff. That's kind of cool. Tell us about that.
Well, I mean... We had a Fortune article today. We're gonna have GJL's gonna have an official announcement next week on Tuesday. But basically, we are in charge or running a global tournament for the Olympic Games for a video game portion, like a welcome event. I have to be really careful with how I say
that. Yeah, for someone who spent all day on it, you just sound like you don't know fucking dick about it.
No, because it's so complicated, and you can only word things in certain ways that you have to be very careful in
how
you
say things. The official announcement
is coming
out Monday, correct?
Basically, we're like we're holding a welcoming event, which is basically a finals of a video game tournaments that we're going to hold all around the world. The winners are going to be flown to Shanghai, and they're going to compete at the Olympic Games in this welcoming event. And for prizes and stuff, I'm sure. Actually, it's not for prizes. I think they just compete to win, and the prize is just going in general. So, but anyway, anybody will be able to play. If you don't have to be the best Quake player in the world. If you're an awesome Guitar Hero player or awesome at Bejeweled, you might be able to go. So, but we haven't announced the list of games. Registration opens on February 25th. Details as far as games and other information, that's going to be coming. But
next
it's
week,
pretty
right?
exciting that video games and Marcus, you should be, or djWheat, however you want to be called, should be very excited because, I mean, esports.
Look at this face.
Has esports made it now?
Don't I look?
It's recognized.
I don't know. Has it, man?
It's sort of, now it's sort of in the same breath as Olympics.
I'm more happy that all these people that think like, GGL is a teetering company. Well... Yo, dog, Beijing fucking Olympics. That seemed very teetering to you, bitches. No. I didn't think so.
It's kind of a big deal.
Yeah. Oh, kind of a big deal.
A big deal.
If people want to say, and let me put this in a comparison, Suma. Exhibition events, things like Taekwondo.
Right.
things like ping pong. These were not initially events at the
Olympics. Yeah.
These were introduced to the Olympics in the exact same way that gaming is being introduced.
Can you imagine
this year.
5 years from now, Counter-Strike, you get a gold medal and you know, like Counter-Strike.
God, let's hope
like
it's not Counter-Strike.
Or you know what I mean. But it's like that's kind of exciting.
I'm camping.
It's kind of a big. It is a big deal. It is a big deal for video games and
it is
and a respectability factor and all that.
I gotta say, you know, a lot of this has to do with the fact that the Olympics this year is going to be in Beijing. Because had the Olympics been, let's say, in the United States, I don't know if there would have been that big of a draw. But I've been to China twice this year,
yes.
And not only does China love us, but that they will fucking fill stadiums. Because I watched them twice this year fill up stadiums of people absolutely fucking rabid to watch,
and
you know, Spirit Moon play Warcraft 3.
I mean, it wouldn't be far out of the realm of possibility to see more people at these digital games that we're going to be hosting than and at you know Olympic events. So
that's right.
Especially
that
curling.
Fuck, like, what is it? Synchronized swimming.
Yeah.
Warcraft 3 is where it's at. All right, we've got our first caller on the horn, dude. Let me go ahead and put up our number. First off, you can Skype the show. Just fire up Skype at Epileptic Gaming and fire a call over to us. Or if you're one of those handy technological wizards that can use all sorts of cool gadgetry, you can dial this phone number right there. That's 1-866-408-4445.
Hey,
is that phone number right, by the way? Someone let me know.
Can I just say something about phone calls? If you have already called and gotten through, please don't call back unless it's super important. Let's let other
people.
Dude,
come on. You're going to let people gauge if their call is super
saying,
important?
I'm just
like
saying.
That, you just gave them free will
if
to call back.
You had your chance.
They
let
may
someone
think
else
that,
have theirs.
They may think that it's super important that they just played their Wii. And now you've just given them a fucking open invitation to do that. With that being said, we got PC Gamer 11 on the horn. And sorry to keep you waiting so long, bro, but welcome to the show.
Not too bad, fellas. How's it going?
It's going.
I had some news I saw online today. I had to get off my chest. I'm really starting to get tired of companies like Activision starting to really milk their franchises
I to
here
talk
with this
about
new
this.
Aerosmith Guitar Hero thing they're doing. Did you guys see that?
Yeah, this is what I would give the Guitar Hero franchise right here for that.
I'm pretty much on that boat.
Is that not the
after
biggest
GH3
fuck you?
Came out, you know, and then I saw Rock Band. Me and my friends keep playing Rock Band every week, and we saw this news, and I'm just thinking.
Well,
how do they think that's
not
a good idea?
Guys,
how do they think that is a good idea?
I'll tell you why they think, because the Guitar Hero brand has turned into like fucking Smurfs of the 80s.
Yeah,
dude.
But
like they're branding it with everything. And
but
actually,
gamers nowadays
Kotaku,
care about Aerosmith?
Well, I don't know, but on Kotaku, I want to also find. I want to find this because they had an interesting article, and the article was, check this out right here, okay? This just goes to show how much the Guitar Hero franchise is about to get whored out, okay?
We already said that. I mean, there was already that rumor that like six different Guitar Heroes would be coming
out
this year.
So we've seen that crappy little put it on your fucking belt buckle and play some song.
Yeah, that's not.
We now see, well, I mean, what the hell is this thing, dude?
Yeah, I saw that today. I was like, oh my gosh.
I mean, these guys are branding the fuck out of Guitar Hero franchise. And, you know, in one aspect, you got to look at it from a business point of view. That's the smart thing to do. On the other side of it.
You're ruining your franchise.
Let me ask you this, guys. If it would have happened, PC Gamer 11, if this would have happened, let's say, a year ago, before Rock Band came out, when Guitar Hero was still the staple of guitar rhythm games, with the exception of Guitar Freaks, which will still own all. But we'll get into that discussion later. Had this happened, had this whole like brand whoring of Guitar Hero happened a year ago before the phenomenon that was Rock Band, would you be any more okay with it?
No, because last year, if you remember, they did that horrible Rocks the 80s shit for
$50. Oh my god.
Bucks.
There was like one good fucking song on that whole freaking album.
What a disgusting.
Exactly.
Piece
that's
of trash.
Where it started, and it's even just going times 100 with all these pseudo expansion packs they're going to be releasing. And I guarantee that they're probably going to release this the same price they did Rock's 80s last year at 50 bones for a few songs and not even a full campaign mode that they did, you know, with the regular Guitar Heroes.
I really
so
don't understand that.
I just don't get this. And they're really going to lose a lot of their fans. And I really hope people do not buy this crap when it comes out in a few months.
Oh, I hope they don't either. But honestly, how many people bought rocks the 80s or Encore to the 80s.
I can't imagine a lot.
I mean, I actually, maybe a lot of people did.
I used to work at a GameStop last year for a while, and surprisingly, there were a lot of people coming in slapping down some
because they didn't know better at that point.
You gotta stop doing that.
Yeah, so. and maybe they do
maybe
know
there's
better.
There's an
now.
Audience. Maybe it's something we don't know about. I don't know. But I can't imagine there's a lot. I mean, but maybe like 200,000 to 500,000 copies sold is enough for Activision to be like, yeah, you know what? This is going to be successful. And I would be very willing to bet that they sell between 200 and 500K of Aerosmith Guitar Hero, which is a goddamn shame.
Absolutely.
But I imagine that's going to happen, and Activision's going to look at him like, hey, it's a success. We're going to keep on raping it.
So can I ask you guys a question? Like, do you think Guitar Hero or Activision and related parties are ever going to wise up? And we're going to see them try to basically copy what Rock Band has done. I mean, because right now, I just don't... I mean, I like playing Guitar Hero, don't get me wrong. But last night, I had a chance to play some more Rock Band. And I played all the Oasis songs. And you know what? I was telling Suma, I was like, you know what? These Oasis songs are so fucking cool because you got to play them like you're strumming an acoustic guitar. And never once in the Guitar Hero series did I ever sort of have that experience.
Well, yeah,
like,
it's more arcade-y.
Yeah.
Just like watching you guys up all night on Rock Band, you guys and your guests had some good points about comparing the two. And it seems like Rock Band now is a staple party game because you can get all your friends involved with different instruments. It's not just the guitar; you can play the drums and singing
right.
and all that.
Is there room
for both? Guitar Hero seems
because
Guitar Hero seems more like a DDR kind of thing, whereas DDR is not necessarily about dancing, but it's more about, you know, hitting the points and rhythms and all that stuff at the right points, and it's about remembering, you know, patterns and things
it's
like that.
It's all about the paradise.
Guitar Hero on Expert is more about remembering patterns and hitting them at certain points and blah, 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 whereas Rock Band is more just a natural feeling of playing the music.
Yeah, I think Rock Band just brought it back to being more fun. GH started out that way, and I think you know, Harmonix and EA is just bringing it up to that next level as far as fun factor and ease of in the ease of play for all parties. So
we'll see. I'm not a huge fan of Aerosmith, so I wasn't exactly
me neither, dude.
Creaming my pants over that. What was that noise?
This is you guys the next quote unquote craze to hit the United States, even though it didn't quite do it yet. There's a game that tried to follow Dance Dance Revolution, and the game was called Para Para Paradise. And what it did, you're gonna see this, check this out right here. Okay, see, so you use your hands instead of your feet.
Oh, so
look at how fucking cool this guy looks.
Oh,
right,
yeah, because they look even.
Yeah. Hey,
that looks so
hey, lady, get out of the fucking way. I can't see him para-paring. Look at that, dude. Suma, can you see yourself doing that?
No,
like,
but I could see some big, fat, sweaty.
All
right,
now check this out. Now check this out, okay? Right? So, basically, this kind of turned into...
How is that dancing? It's just arm movement.
Well, it's not really, but see what happened, and let me switch it back here. What happened is that, like, in Japan, this became a ridiculous, ridiculous sensation.
Oh, I'm sure.
And so people...
A pooping game would be a sensation.
People would do... All right, so check this out. People would do, basically, like, para-para-paradise video or dancing... Without even having...
Be like, how much can you poop?
Without even having the machine. So, like, here's an
I
example.
I poop in the middle for
so
100 points.
They're doing now a para-para routine, or
oh
they will be.
Oh, my God.
Right, but they have no machine in front of them.
I think our nuclear bombs did something to them, where now they're this advanced alien race.
Look at that. Look at that. Are you guys ready for that? Fuck Guitar Hero. Fuck Rock Band. It's all about para-para-paradise.
I'd like to.
There's a new reality show for you.
What? Para-para?
Yep.
Yeah, exactly. So, anyway, I know that we kind of got off topic there, and that was all my fault. And let me shut that the hell up.
You could have just
shut the fucking up, video.
I wonder if she was hot.
I think that's a guy, dude.
Yeah. Happened yeah. before.
Yeah, it has.
Nobody
has
likes
it.
Surprise.
Epic trap! All right, PC Gamer, what do you think, real quickly before I let you go, what do you think about, you know, the PC market right now?
I used to be a big PC gamer, like a lot of people, and then I switched to
is
consoles.
That why your name is PC Gamer?
Yeah, I get that a lot, too, because that's my Xbox Live tag, too, and a lot of people give me crap for that, but... I used to be big into StarCraft and the shooters back in the day, but then early 2000s, I picked up, you know, PS2 and then Xbox later on. It just it's a more natural flow.
You sound like me.
I think the like that Savage 2 guy said the other day, that I think it's the boom of console market, not necessarily the huge decline of the PC thing. I think that's really what it boils down to.
Yeah, exactly. The market expanded. The market expanded. Consoles are easier to digest and play, and yeah, it just makes sense. That's why, you know, you just got to take things in perspective.
Because I think PC gaming used to be where it was like me, the guys that would go to Fry's and like, oh, man, I got to build myself a computer to compete with the graphics market. Yeah. And it was that kind of crowd. Now anybody can go pick up a $300 or $400 console, and now the Wii you can pick up for $200, whatever. But now it's just a lot more affordable for people, and it's a lot more casual. So I think that's how the market's really grown. So.
But there are some great, there's going to be some good PC games coming out in the near future.
Oh, definitely, yeah. I mean, like you guys saying, Spore is coming out now. Finally, they got a date for that. I think if they still got some innovation on that kind of note, then there'll still be a market for it.
There was that like crossover PC shooter game that was like a hybrid multiplayer single player game. I forget what it was called, like Crossfire. Or something.
What are you talking about?
You remember that Crossfire game that was announced like a few months ago, or something like that, where like they were being really ambitious, where you were playing a single player game, and instead of NPCs, another player could drop in and be the body of like a random jobber and like try and kill. Yeah. Wow. I forget what it was called.
I'm not sure.
Yeah.
I'm not sure. Well, PZ Gamer, thanks for your comments, dude.
Not too bad, guys. Thanks.
Take care. Bye. I'm not sure how thanks for the comments turned into not too bad, but.
Are you just talking to yourself, or
I was trying to process that last statement, and as I told you, I've been taking some Benadryl today, so we've got your favorite. Oh man, Talkwork almost got picked up, but instead we're gonna take Tokyo Vigilante. Welcome to the show. What's up, brother?
Hey, how's it going, guys?
It's going fantastic, but not really.
All right. One quick thing before I get to my questions. I've been to a couple of conventions in my time, and I've seen one too many people doing that para-para stuff, sans machine, and yeah, it ain't fun.
Scary shit, dude.
Yeah.
It's scary shit.
Watch very true, them. Very true.
Wheat's a DDR elitist. any other gay game that might came along and take the gay crown, he's going to defend it.
All right, guys. Lost. That's what I want to get to right now.
Lost.
Yeah, yeah. It's Lost.
All right. So if you haven't watched Lost, then GTFO, dude.
Earmuffs.
Yep, earmuffs. What do you got to say, dude?
Dude, you know what? I don't think I can keep on watching that show, man. Like,
what?
At this point,
get out. Get out. No.
What?
Why?
Like, after last night's reveal and everything, how could you say that?
Lost is better than ever.
I honestly don't feel like I can watch it for another two seasons. I'm just pretty much gonna wait till they reveal the last two people and just wait till the last episode, because there's so much stuff at this point in time that they haven't revealed yet, and it's pissing me off.
So you're complaining about all the stuff.
But hold on. If you take into consideration the amount of answers versus questions that they've already given this season, then we're already like in the positive.
The reason I love Lost is all the theories and all the stuff they throw at you. The fact, like, just talking about it and thinking about what it could possibly be, and reasons why it's not, and all, like, that's what's exciting to me.
Tokyo Vigilante, let me tell you something. You know what? Because I know where you're coming from, right? Like, what the fuck is the black smoke? Why did we see a four-toed statue? These are the types of questions that they've just, like, thrown out there to sort of, like, mind fuck us.
Well, other civilizations are there, right? That's why
here's my thought on it, and this has nothing to do with the show, but it has everything to do with Ubisoft's comments about them making the Lost game, okay? Mm. Now, when Ubisoft did this interview, I believe it was Game Informer that I read it, one of the main things that they asked them was, like, how did you create a video game out of the show without knowing the secrets? And they were like, well, actually, we had to find out the secrets. Like, the Lost producers or the creative team behind it actually went to Ubisoft and said, okay, this is how the black creature operates. Racist. Like you can't it can't do this, but it can do this. It can't go here, but it can go here. So they basically like laid out all of these rules and all of these things.
Trying to keep a black
monster down. So, you know, the bottom line being is that it was like every time I think that maybe these guys have no fucking clue what they want to do with this show, I hear something like that and realize these guys know exactly what they're doing with the show, man. They are, I mean, yeah, they're going to keep on giving us questions and, you know, maybe a few answers here and there, but there will be a point where everything will be revealed. And I think that at that point, it's going to be the equivalent to me of the first time playing through BioShock and getting to the epic part that we all know of. And I think it's pretty much long overdue. I think the spoiler has been given away, but the would you kindly moment where suddenly everything that you've just done in the game for the past 15 hours translates into one line that one guy says. And that's why, I think the show fucking rocks, man.
I see what you're saying. But at the same time, I don't know, like, I'm just hoping they do start answering questions soon, because at this point I'm starting to kind of lose interest, because like you said, they've never answered like the black smoke monster. They never answered that 6 foot tall fucking foot statue.
So, but you would rather just stop watching and never like find out about it rather than sticking with it, or what?
Well, not really, because the thing is that, like you said, like they're probably going to answer it around the end of the series, and I'm assuming they're going to wait till season 6 to pretty much give you like the gist of like what's going on. And
I don't know. I mean, they've already revealed to us pretty much who the Oceanic Six are, with the exception of one. And
that's true.
You know, and the other thing that kind of that kind of blew my mind last night is that, do you remember the first flashback or flash forward episode that they had? It was actually the season finale of season three with Jack and Kate. And in the
was Kate shown?
Yes, Kate was at the end.
Okay,
yes. So in this particular episode, if you remember, Jack goes to a funeral and no one's there at this funeral, okay? I'm assuming that that individual is someone from the island or someone that is in Oceanic 6. But I thought...
It's the black kid.
I thought for sure that it was Ben.
I think it's a black kid.
But now we know that Ben isn't dead. So, you know, like, I don't know. I just love it when they blast the doors fucking wide open on there. But Sumi, you've kind of been quiet over there. Like, what's your thoughts here? Should Tokyo give up or what?
No, like I said, you know what intrigues me about Lost are the theories and like the ideas behind it. And the fact that last night that they introduced, you know, that time element fascinates me even more, because I love any show that starts to talk about time and the complexities behind it and time travel and all that stuff and wormholes. Like, that kind of stuff always, like, interests me. Even going back, you know, I always bring it up. There's this Men in Black cartoon episode that deals with time travel that's absolutely amazing. And I know you're making that face, but I fucking loved it. I wish I could watch it again. But anyway.
The fact that you've seen the Men in Black cartoon is what
I used
much
to watch it
me.
In my dorm in college. But there was this one episode that dealt with time travel and, like, the problems that it can cause and all this stuff. And it was a great episode. But anyway.
Have you ever seen Primer before, dude?
I don't think so.
I'm going to give you that DVD.
Okay.
It's about these guys that build a little time machine, and they start fucking with it, and it's pretty crazy. Anyway.
All right, well, one thing, Sumo, real quick. Yeah, I know what episode you're talking about, and I'm right with you, man. That episode rocked. And
Right on.
And I just want to know also if you guys knew if like any DS hacking sites, because I know like I'm into PSP hacking and stuff. I got my PSP hacked already. And
what are you looking for?
What happened?
What are you looking for?
Just anything that doesn't really involve the R4, because I'm not one of those 99% of North Americans that have it.
Not going to happen. Homebrew capable R4. It's the only way to go, bro. All
right, man. All right.
Now, but keep in mind that, you know, you don't have to get an R4 and just instantly turn it into a ROM pirate, okay? You can get an R4 and have homebrew capabilities, which is what a lot of people do.
Oh, okay.
You know, it's no different than, if you're familiar with the PSP hacking, it's no different from them having the homebrew support and the firmware, the custom firmwares. So, you know, the R4 basically acts like a physical custom firmware. That's how you got to look at it. That's really the only route I know you can take. I believe there might be a mod chip. Do you think you want to open up your DS?
No.
You want to stick a fucking cartridge into it, dude. That you want to take the easy route. So, unfortunately, there's really no other solutions aside from that. And if there are, I'd love to hear them. But that's just based off of what I know.
All right, guys. Well, thanks and peace out.
Peace. All right.
That, good that, string of calls so far.
It was Tokyo Vigilante. Talkwork is trying to call in. Should I?
You want to end the streak of good calls?
I'm picking it up. Talkwork, you're on the air. What's up, bro?
How you guys doing? Epileptic gaming is officially cool.
Oh, officially.
Yeah, officially.
Major ass. Right.
That's not what Stephen Hawking says. He says we suck major ass.
Well, he was incorrect.
What the
anyway,
hell are you
that
going
was,
over
that,
there?
Was the EG, that was the EG Hawking exercise revolution, but we won't get into that. What's up, dude?
This is a question, djWheat. Would you kindly tell us about the mana potions?
Would you kindly?
Listen to talk. Yes. Trying to be all on top.
What
of
do you
it.
Want to know about them, dude? I took one before the show.
Said that you were going to give them out one of these days?
Yeah.
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 Yeah. Yes, we are. So, yes, we are.
Okay.
It's not going to be good. Today, bro.
Snap.
Snap.
I watched Lost yesterday. It's real good. I just got interested.
A voice
and
of reason.
I just started watching it.
Oh, so you haven't
Dude,
even watched
catch
the whole
up,
series?
Because you're not even having yeah. appreciating what's going
I haven't.
I
before the new episode, they kind of did a one episode where they basically
oh yeah that was a good episode too.
Which one?
The one that they showed before the season premiere on
yeah,
ABC.
Yeah, and basically told you
oh,
some
yeah,
stuff.
Oh yeah, I like that one a lot.
Mason. Yeah, that was real good and kind of got me really interested
but
in
still.
The show. No.
It's amazing that they were able to do that in 60 minutes, to be totally honest with you. You're talking
yeah,
to, I mean you're no shit
there
talking
was a lot,
about like,
let's be honest, there was a lot of filler in the early part of season 2.
Yeah, yeah, you're right. You're right. There's a lot. Actually,
been,
season one
been,
is all filler,
there's
too.
There's been some filler like, episodes.
Yeah, but like. if you get a chance to catch up, you should definitely do so, for sure.
I plan to do it this weekend, probably download season one and season two and watch
get
it.
Get it on Blu-ray, brother.
Yeah.
It was
the new
is it
the
true
new
that
champ of high def.
I think only season three is on Blu-ray, though.
Well, what's that character's name, the bald guy? I forgot his
Locke.
Name. He's
Locke.
Lock. Is it true that he was like handicapped before he?
Yes,
it is true.
He was in a, well, his father, his bastard father, threw him out after taking his kidney, and threw Lock out a window.
He fell 6 stories onto his back, broke it.
My God!
And when he landed on the island, he suddenly had
somehow.
His yeah. So yeah. Actually, that definitely comes into
Ouch.
Play because
oh.
the people of the island are kind of like, dude, who is this guy, and why was he healed?
And like. Isn't he like the leader now because he basically read a bunch of books or something? I heard he just kind of
dude.
Got
do me a favor, oh. watch, please go back
and
talk
work. Some guys
show.
In Stick'em just made a good note. They said every episode is available online on ABC.
Oh yeah, in
so,
high def too.
Yeah, so if you want to catch
there?
Up, just go to ABC.com.
Yeah, ABC.com. Really, all episode now. There's small commercials in there, but dude, do not be afraid. I'm actually firing up here. Check this out right there, abc.com. And yeah, look at all these. They got full. Look at this. Lost Season 1 in HD streaming right here.
That's why the writers oh, went on strike.
Yeah. Booyah.
Oh, there I am.
Yep.
Oh, my God.
What? Why did I install something? So Damn. You're going to need to install Damn. Something in order Damn. For it to work. But there you go. You got it. God,
oh,
look
I
at
am.
How young Walt looks there.
Look how young I look on the bottom. Just look at you. Young, fresh face. Just on the plane.
Jobber face. All right, talk or anything
I
else?
I have something about the Cliffy B incident. You know, what? About Epic
the
Games.
The Cliffy B incident? Consoles. What?
I mean, going towards consoles and everything. I understand that because, I mean, PC gaming isn't dead. It's frozen. It's way behind
it just
right
stabilized.
Now.
Let's be honest.
Just give it some time. It'll get back. It's just, let's call it a
oh,
drought.
I'm sure it will with yeah. Microsoft's help and that brilliant Games for Windows program they're doing. Sure
hey, did right you guys hear that the next PS3s are shipping with a Linux install on them?
Ooh.
Ooh.
I just thought that was interesting based off of what you said, but I think you're kind of PC gaming is in stasis right now.
Yes, it is. And, well, one of the reasons because of the shitty-ass half, you know, the shitty-ass ports. Kane and Lynch port, Gears of War.
Because it's not a priority. Any game that's going to go cross-platform, the PC version's not going to be all that.
Unreal kind of had a porty menu or something like that, some people's been saying.
A what?
A porty menu?
It seems that the HUD and, you know, all the screens in there feel like it's for a console.
Oh, yeah. Well, of course. I mean, a lot of these games are developed for console, you know, like.
Next caller.
All right.
Thank you, Talkwork.
GG and all. Peace.
Peace, dog. Peace. Suma spoke.
Well, I mean, other people are trying to get in. That's all
right. We got Ashnot on the horn. What's up, dude?
What's up, guys?
Hey, what's going on, man?
He's calling from Iraq?
No,
about
Spain.
The Linux PS3 thing, it's not that all PS3s will be released with Linux. It's just that the company that makes Linux for the PS3 will ship... is selling PS3s on their website, and
I must have read it wrong. I'm gonna see if I can find the article. Well, you didn't fucking know about it, Suma. So shut your fucking mouth.
I don't care about Linux.
Well, you should kind of care about
why.
Oh my God.
I don't care. Why should I care?
Why should you care?
Most gamers that are going to game on the PS3 do not
give a fuck. You're right. You shouldn't care about anything that could possibly help the potential PS3 sales. My bad. I forgot. You're a fucking
Linux
Wii fanboy,
tools,
dude. My bad. I didn't mean
Linux,
to bring it up, bro.
You think Linux tools will add a significant amount
are
to PS3
kidding,
sales?
Dude?
Are you
do you
kidding,
realize,
dude?
Do you
are
realize
you kidding, dude?
Piracy. Homebrew.
Yeah,
these
that's
are
a
things
small
that sell
percentage.
Systems.
Yeah, a small percentage. I said it will not affect a significant amount of PS3 sales. Just
I think
like,
wrong.
I think you're out of touch with reality if you think Linux tools will help push a significant amount of PS3s. That's anything over 10 to 15%.
All right, well, I guess, I mean, whatever... I can't seem to...
Most PS3 owners probably don't even know how to use fucking remote play, God for God's sakes. You think they're going to understand Linux?
No, but see, exactly. I operate on a level of fucking intelligent individuals.
That's fine,
so
but
I shouldn't have even expected you to fucking know
there.
It. So, sorry. was freely available, blah, blah, blah.
Jesus.
For an uninitiated, anyone looking for a more redefined and prepackaged approach to getting Linux on their PlayStation 3 should look no further than the yellow dog for Sony's official sanctioned build.
Yeah, that's the one.
Gotcha. So I'm going to have to find the other article. This is actually just announcing the yellow dog Linux thing, but thanks for clearing that up. I'm going to try to find the original article where I read that. Because they were going to, you know, from what I read, it was going to be available, on like boot, but yeah. Anything else, dude?
Have you seen the Street Fighter leaks that came out from Tokyo?
Yes.
Did you see them?
Yes, I did. What did you guys think of them? I thought they were quite awesome.
I thought it looks cool. I've been excited about this game. I've been excited.
I'm more excited about the H3 remix for the second one.
No.
That's coming for download XBLA and PSN.
I don't care.
I just don't like the art style.
You don't? I like the art style. I like that it looks super high res, but I think that this looks way more badass. And I wish that it was out already, pretty much. But I'm trying to find one.
Yeah,
of these
right now. I think that when it come out, it will blow everyone's mind. But right now, in the pics that come out aren't that high res. Yeah, so it... it's a bit early for me to say anything, but right now I'm not that excited. But that's just me.
Well, of the fourth one.
Yeah, I don't know. I just everyone seems so. I don't know.
As someone who doesn't care about fighting games anymore and stopped caring about them about 10 to 15 years ago, I must say I am pretty excited about this new version. The HD remix, not so much. I don't really care. It's because I don't really care about, you know, classic games all that much. Or Chachi Ramirez.
This is the characters trailer, you guys. And
I think that looks hot, dude.
Dude, why are these Japanese dudes
way? Get the version of them playing.
Well, we've got that too, if you want to see it.
What do you think about that Viper chick? It's kind of hot. You know, I think that looks pretty cool, dude.
Oh, it looks cool, but even more impressive is how it looks like
fluid, dude.
Yeah, it looks fluid, and it looks like they have truly...
Do you think this could spark a rebirth in fighting games?
I hope it can.
I like that they keep it in this sort of flat landscape that's not over... Like, it's not 3D at all, is it? It's still locked in.
It's completely 3D, but on a 2D plane.
Yeah, I kind of like that. It's like Guilty Gear, because I liked playing the Guilty Gear franchise because it was still on that 2D. I think that looks cool.
Yeah, I'm very excited for this.
Nice.
As you can see here, it does look badass.
Blanca!
And I don't think we've seen all of it yet, but I mean, it looks like it really is like fucking old school fighting, you know? That's what's exciting about it to me.
I just think it looks beautiful, man. It really does. I hope the people in the background are completely random, though. I like the actions they were doing.
Oh, you mean like this, like the guy sitting there?
Yeah, the guy cheering. Look at that guy's got his hand on his chin.
Boom. Peace, buddy.
Look at God.
You know, the one thing about this is it looks like there's really like, I mean, it looks like they have not made any attempt at like increasing the moves.
Oh, that's
list.
Cool. It's going to have close ups like that when you do a power move?
Yeah, in special moves.
Dude, it looks like an anime. Like, it looks like you're playing an anime.
This could be what fans have really wanted for a long time.
Yeah. I think it's pretty hot.
And you know what,
I like
you
the
guys?
Way they move.
This is a great example of how you don't necessarily have to change a fucking damn thing about your game in order to, like, sell. I mean, this to me looks
it's
like...
It's a completely updated version.
Right. It looks like... But at the same time, while it's completely updated, it looks like... you know, it looks like its 2D counterpart. If that makes sense. It plays like its 2D counterpart.
It should. That'd be awesome.
Right, exactly. Like, they didn't really have to add more moves. It doesn't have to be like Tekken where it's got, you know, each character has like 80,000 fucking different moves to do. It's like, it looks like you have your low, you know, or light punch, medium punch, heavy punch, you know, your six buttons just like you would normally expect. And
I'm not sure how much this will sell in the States, but I do imagine
it will
do
pretty well. Are
you kidding
me, dude? Street Fighter is fucking popular in the States.
I know,
States,
but
dog.
I'm not sure that hardcore audience is there's enough people. Just looking at the software
you really
charts
think
every
so?
Month, just seeing what's on top of the charts every month, it'll be interesting to see. I think in Japan it could probably do really well. But
I would put a bet that it's going to do phenomenal.
I hope it does. I kind of like it.
Ashnod, thanks for your call, dude.
Bye.
All right, bye. We got about 10 minutes to the top of the hour, so let's take maybe one more phone call here. And we got Chains 20 on
the air.
What
do you think will do better, Tekken 6 or Street Fighter 4?
Oh, I think Street Fighter 4, hands down.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, come on. Tekken's had like 3 or 4, maybe even 5 games. Mm. And while, it can be considered a well-established franchise, I think that if you pulled any random person on the street, like if we just basically walked the street, you know, and said, do you know what Street Fighter is? And then ask them, do you know what Tekken is? I guarantee you that we'll have more individuals say.
Do you think that Street Fighter 4 will do better than Super Smash Brothers Brawl?
Do you think Street Fighter 4 will do better than Smash Brothers?
Do you think Smash Brothers Brawl will be the king of fighters this year?
No, you know why I think Street Fighter 4 will do better? Because it will automatically be multi-platform. So
I know there's a lot of unused Wii consoles out there.
There are. I lost.
There's a lot more to play on the other consoles than there are on the Wii. So I would imagine a lot of Wii owners will be playing Super Smash Brothers Brawl. And I imagine a lot of people bought the Wii just so they could play Super Smash Brothers Brawl. Whereas people that own PS3 and 360, you know, they bought it to play actual games. So,
all right, let's take one quick caller here. Matthew, last caller at the top of the hour. What's up, dude?
What's up, guys? What do you think about Walmart and Blu-ray?
I think fucking done deal, bro. Done deal.
We told you so a long time ago.
We told you so.
Fuck you, all the people that said that we were bullshit. Fuck you, all the people that said Blu-ray would never make it. Everyone that made fun of us. Everyone that talked shit to us about it. We told you so. Okay?
that'll actually weigh into my decision to either get a PS3 or 360.
Well, of course it fucking
should. It should, man.
I know, but the thing is, I've never really been one for HD. I mean, as long as I play
games. No, hold on. Dude. Stop right there. You said you've never really been one for HD. And that's because you haven't experienced
it,
dude.
I mean,
dude, it looks nice. Let's not be okay. What looks nice is going from like RCA to fucking S video. Okay, that looks nice. That's a little sharper. Okay, going from like S video or component to like DVI or HDMI. No, that does not look nice. That looks fucking beautiful, brother.
And we, can you please set people straight? Because I still see this argument, this retarded argument of people going, oh, well, HD download on 360 is just as good.
It's not. It's not. Yeah. It's a fucking gimped HD, people, okay? They can't get. They can't send you the throughput that they need to actually achieve. And let's talk about this for a moment, okay? And Matthew, sorry. I mean, if you want to stay on, I'm going to explain this. Then we're going to take our break, and then I'll let you come back, all right? So all just right. stay on the horn for a second. I'm gonna mute you for just a second here. Guys. All right, here's how it fucking works, all right? You get HD through your cable box, don't you? Well, you think you do, but you don't really. Yeah, the picture looks nice, but when you when you watch a video, you're watching like say a YouTube video. That's like 150 kilobits, all right? A normal signal, maybe a live stream, it's about 500, 700 kilobits, and you can tell it looks kind of shitty. All right, so HD cable streaming is allegedly 22,000 kilobytes. Okay, that sounds great. Okay, 22,000 kilobytes. That's a big fucking number. Mm-hmm. And compared to like 150 kilobytes that you see on YouTube, yeah, you should see some quality difference. But here's what's important, okay? The next time you load up your PS3, if you have one, go ahead and hit select while you're watching a Blu-ray movie and pay attention to that fucking number that tells you the throughput of what your Blu-ray is sending to your PS3. That number isn't 22,000. That number isn't 33,000. That number is fucking 48,000, okay? So your fucking high-def downloads from Xbox Live, those are 22,000 kilobits if you're lucky, okay? That's like fucking half of HD, all right? So while it looks better and while you think it's HD, it's still compressed, guys.
Yeah,
it's
completely uncompressed.
It's still fucking compressed.
The audio alone in Blu-ray, to me, as I've said before, makes it worth it. I am... You know, I love music. I love, you know, concerts and watching music in HD. And the Blu-ray uncompressed alone for me is worth it. Let's not even get into the picture.
Yeah, absolutely. So the bottom line is that, first off, your fucking Microsoft HD downloads are not really HD downloads, okay? They're more equivalent to, like, what you would see if you're watching high-def cable over your cable box. A fucking Blu-ray or even an HD DVD, not so much, is an uncompressed format. And now that Blu-ray has obviously been crowned the clear winner, despite the fact that Toshiba has not axed it yet, that will happen in May, and at that point we'll have a giant fucking party. Yes.
Tenet says it doesn't matter if your TV is under 40 inches.
What do you mean it doesn't
Professor
matter?
Professor Tenet.
What do you mean it doesn't fucking
PC
matter?
PC gaming is not dead fame.
Well, you know, first off, it does matter, okay? I have a 32-inch Samsung CRT widescreen, 720p, and even on an up-converted 1080i signal, it fucking looks better than any other signal that I could possibly send it. Yes, there are HDMI inputs on this television, this 32-inch. I can clearly tell the difference. I can clearly tell the difference, okay? Now, a fucking 40-inch Bravia, 1080p, you could tell the fucking difference, bro. In fact, as they start getting higher... It's easier to tell the difference. It's easier to tell what's fucking standard broadcast. It's easier to tell what's true HD. And even for me, it's pretty easy to tell when I'm watching gimped HD fucking signals. So with that being said, I would like to come back to this discussion.
But I think it's important for us to say this. And I know some of you in Stigma were like, oh, I already knew this. But I guarantee you a lot of you probably didn't. And there's a lot of misinformation out there. There's a lot of confusion. And as well, there should be. I mean, a lot of people just don't spend the time to get to know this stuff. That's why I wanted we to kind of explain it, because I know people will come up with that argument. I've seen it in our own forums. I've seen it in other forums where there's supposedly intelligent people floating around and they still use that bullshit. Download content is better than Blu-ray.
Right.
No, it's not.
It's not. And it never will be.
And
until
be
we have fucking Fios and fiber optics running through the United States, and then it's not a big deal. Until we have that, our infrastructure in the United States is not prepared for a fucking digital distribution method that is going to give you a true high-def signal. And for anyone who wants to argue that, they need to just fucking go read something. I don't know. Like, it's so easy to tell. Like, I download these trailers and shit, and I just laugh because they're not, you know, it's not even close to what true HD or Blu-ray can achieve. And I'm not even saying that only Blu-ray can achieve that. I'm saying that HD DVD can as well.
We seem to have lost everyone in Stick'em.
What,
for
really?
A second.
Well, that's good. Guess what?
I guess
because
they're all joining back.
It's
now.
Time for
I don't
a
know
break.
What happened? Oh, they said, "Wow, what the fuck? What the hell?"
I don't know. I don't know, guys. We're gonna it was perfect timing, guys, because it's time for a break. We're gonna take a little like 5 minute something, and we come back. We've got more Faces for Radio from Epileptic Gaming. I'm DJ Wheat, of course, the world famous Robert Suma joining me, and we'll be
stay
right
here,
back.
Stay here, folks.
Just stay here, or you will die.
Yeah.